We come to bow down in the name of Jesus. We come to give you the praise, God. We come to give you the praise, God. We come to give you the praise. We lift up your name. We lift up your name, God. King of kings and Lord of lords, my God. There's no other God like you. There's no other God like you, my soul.
Amen. Thank you, family, for praying. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Well, it is Friday. It is Friday. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have made it a whole week, and we are studying settlement warrant. Settlement warrant. Today, our topic is the Philistine Intimidators won. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Says that the Philistines discourage you in order to put your dreams beyond your reach. They put fear into you and make you run away from the battle. And in the battle with Israel, the Philistines put forward a giant champion by the name Goliath and challenged Israel to present their champion. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Samuel's 1:17-8. And there went out a champion out of the camp of the Philistines named Goliath of Gath, whose height was 6 cubits and a span. And he had a helmet of brass upon his head, and he was armed with a coat of mail. And the weight of the coat was 5,000 shekels of brass. And he had grievous of brass upon his legs and a target of brass between his shoulders. And the staff of his spear was like a weaver's beam. And his spearhead weighed 600 shekels of iron. And one bearing a shield went before him. And he stood and cried unto the armies of Israel and said unto them, why are you come out to set your battle in array? Am I not a Philistine and ye servants to Saul? Choose you a man for you and let him come down to me. And we have here where our father, Reverend Eastwood, put the winner of the fight was to determine the outcome of the battle between the two nations. the Israelites was so intimidated, and they feared and trembled at the sight of Goliath. And David appeared and killed him.
Amen.
Our prayer warrant, hallelujah.
Amen.
We're praying for that champion God elects to fight the Goliaths of the Philistines would be released to fight. And many of them are trapped in the wilderness taking care of a few sheep. Did y'all get that right there? Amen.
Amen.
Begin to open up your mouth in the name of Jesus as we fight our Goliaths. We're praying for the champions in the name of Jesus. Father, your word, Romans 8:19 says, for the earnest expectation of the creatures, they waited for the manifestations of the sons of God. The sons of God are you. Oh God, you're not impressed with appearances, God. You don't see things the way that we do in the name of Jesus. Oh God, you look below the surface and see what's in the heart. My God,
homes,
automobiles, material, possessions, to impress others to see position. God, we're calling on the name of Jesus as strong power. We know who the champions are. You may use a vessel, but it is the Holy Ghost that's down in them. Oh God, look upon the hearts in the name of Jesus as you raise up your champions in the name of Jesus. God, help us to discover true motives and the meanings behind the obvious in the name of Jesus. Where are you, David? Lift up your voice and pray for all the Goliaths that are in your life in the name of Jesus and disarm them now by the power in the name of Jesus Christ. We don't come with a sword. We come in the name of Jesus. And just like David knew you was his strength, we know, God, that you are our source. Goliath, in the name of Jesus, we come against you in the name of Jesus by the power, by the word of God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, saints, for praying. Prayer two. We're going to pray that the champions God elects to fight the Goliaths of the Philistine would be adequately rewarded.
Amen.
That too is according to 1 Samuel 17 through, I'm sorry, chapter 17, 25 through 17. Begin to lift up your voice again.
In the name of Jesus.
Lift up your voice again. In the name of Jesus.
Oh,
merciful God.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh, God, when you told Samuel to go to Jesse's house, oh, God, David wasn't there. Oh, God, you don't look on the heart of man, what we wear, what kind of shoes we got on, what kind of education we have. Oh,
Jehovah, you look on the heart in the name of Jesus. Look on the heart of your people in the name of Jesus. We send out, God. We send out the warriors now in the name of Jesus. Man shall not live on bread alone, but out of every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. Open our eyes to see, Jehovah. Open our eyes to see. For the one that we may believe is the David to tear down Goliath. Oh God, that may not even be the person. Oh God, get all the glory, God. Get all the glory, God. Get all the glory, God. God, in the name of Jesus. And we'll be careful to give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Settlement. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The second phase of this prayer is the Philistines Intimidators 2.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's amen. Also out of 1 Samuel 17:48-52 that we read. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Our prayer warrant. Pray that the body of Christ would implore spiritual weapons in the warfare against the Philistines and not carnal weapons. David used a stone instead of a sword. 2 Corinthians 10:3-6. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mightily through God to the pulling down of strongholds,
amen,
casting down imagination and every high thing that would exalt itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ,
amen,
and healing in readiness to revenge all disobedient where your obedience is filled. And prayer too. Pray that the believers would be willing to prepare the armies of the Philistine together instead of leaving the battle to an individual. My God, hallelujah. Begin to lift up your voice in the name of Jesus. Oh God, Father, we do come to you. And in the name of Jesus, God, we obey God's word with the mind. Lord, we know what 2 Timothy says, 1:1-7, God. We thank you, Lord. You have not given us a spirit of fear, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. God, we won't allow fear to rule our minds. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we know that a stronghold, God, is a satanic energy argument set to design to destroy your people, to block God's kingdom purposes in their lives. We pull it down now in the name of Jesus. We pull it down now in the name of Jesus. Oh God, emphasis on flaw. We pull down strongholds by the power of the Holy Ghost. We renew our minds with the word of God. Come on, somebody lift up your voice and pray with me. Let the thunder come out. Let the fire come out. In the name of Jesus, amen. We are going to pray for Reverend Father Eastwood and Mommy Roseman. We're going to pray for them coming this way, and we're praying for the program, the new building, and the Richmond project. We're praying for Father Reverend Eastwood, that traveling grace and mercy favor, that the anointing of the oil on his life will be stretched.
Amen.
That we will see that God is pouring down on his vessel. Amen?
Amen.
We thank you for Mother Roseman, who is his strong prayer warrior, who backs him, who sees and pray, this powerful woman of God. We're praying for the program, that people that are supposed to come here, let them overflow in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, we need resources, God. We need resources, God. Help us, God. Begin to lift up your voice with me and pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, you are the Father of fathers. We put him in your hands. Shout in grace and mercy. Favor. Oh God, surround him in the prayer closet of his counsel. Minister as he ministers unto you. Bless him, Lord God. Let the people that are supposed to be. Let it be an overflow, an overflow, an overflow, an overflow. Use him mightily, strategically, Lord God. Oh God, we'll be careful to give you the glory. We put our new building before you in the name of Jesus. You know what we need and what it takes to get into the land. It's supposed to be in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Rabbi Chima Project, in the name of Jesus. We put it before you. We put it before you. We put it before you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you for praying. We're going to pray for the man of God to bring the word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. John 14:1. John 14:1-3. Says Jesus, the way of to the Father. Don't let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God and trust also in me. There is more than enough room in my Father's home. If this were not so, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And when everything is ready, I will come and get you so that you will always be with me where I am.
Amen.
Where I am.
Amen.
The man of God and the servants all around the world, these are vessels that are standing in the gap on the behalf of Jesus, and they come to bring peace and hope and comfort, deliverance and healing. Begin to lift up your voice with me, family, in the name of Jesus.
Let's bless God. Father, we bless you. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Jesus. Oh,
moment I'm away. Every Thank you. Cornerstone, weak man.
his face. I'll rest on his unchanging grace. In every heart, the stormy gaze. My uncle was within the veil. Let's sing the last verse. When Christ shall come, lift your voice, and the trumpet sound. Oh, may I in him be found, dressed in his righteousness alone. Faultless stand before the throne. Faultless stand before the throne. Come on, give God praise. Hallelujah. Christ alone is the cornerstone, yeah. Weakness is your own, and the Savior's blood through the storm. He is Lord, Lord. Oh, come on, lift your voice. Give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Oh, he's worthy tonight. Hallelujah. Jesus is worthy tonight. Hallelujah. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the name of the Lord shall be praised. Hallelujah. How many of us are ready to lift him up? Even more. Hallelujah. You ready to lift him up? Lift him up. Lift him up. Come on, lift your voice and begin to glorify him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, lift his name up. Lift his name up. Lift his name up. Come on, lift his name up. Lift his name up. Lift his name up. Hallelujah. I don't know what you're going through, but the psalmist says, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. Hallelujah. That means that God is already big, but sometimes your situation wants you to see God smaller. So while you're going through, the psalmist says, magnify. Say magnify. And it means make him bigger. Hallelujah. Make him bigger. Your situations may cause you to be myopic as it relates to the greatness of God. And so the psalmist says, magnify the Lord with me. I believe he's saying to someone who is going through. Hallelujah. Because God is already bigger. God is already great. Hallelujah. But lift up your voice and bless the name of the Lord with me this evening. Come on, lift up your voice. Magnify the Lord with me. Yes, yes, yes. I need some magnifiers. People who make his name great, who make him bigger. Hallelujah. Lift up your voice and make him great. Lift him higher, people. Lift him higher. Yes, we lift you higher. We make you great. Higher, higher. Higher, higher. Higher, higher. Higher. We lift you 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 higher. Oh, Pastor Joe, what are you doing? This thing that you played over there. A song is playing my heart. My Jesus, I love of you, I know thou art mine. For thee, oh, the fullness of sin I resign. If ever I love thee, my Jesus. Now look at the swap. I'm gonna dance and praise him. It doesn't matter what the greater one lives inside of his name. Oh! rejoice in you. I rejoice in you. I rejoice in you. And it makes me more than walk around. Voice say great, great and mighty. You are it. Come on, sing it one more time. Say you are able. You are it. Great and mighty. You are it. Sing it with all your heart. Say, Creator, let's go. Creator of universe. Say, what can you do? Lift your voice. What can you do? What can you do? Jesus. Oh, say, name above. Lift your voice. Name above. What can you change? What can you change? What can't you change, Jesus? Come on, give the Lord a clap offering. Come on, bless him. Lift your voice and bless him. Come on, lift your voice and bless him.
Oh, lift him up. Lift up the name of Jesus. Lift up the name of Jesus. Come on, lift up the name of Jesus. 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 Church, lift up the name of Jesus. We lift up the name of Jesus. We lift up the name of Jesus. The triumphant day. There is healing in his name. There's deliverance in his name. Lift up the name of Jesus in this place. Lift up the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Keep on clapping as we welcome the said man of the house, Pastor Alex Fredua-Agyemang. Come on, keep on blessing God.
Awesome God, how great thou art. Bye.
Let's celebrate Jesus. Let's celebrate Him. Let's celebrate Him. Let's celebrate Him. Somebody give it to Him. Give it to Him. Just lift up your hands and worship him. Worship him. Worship him. Worship him. Worship him. Worship him. You're watching us online. Just join us. Worship Jesus. Lift up your hands and just release yourself to him. Release yourself to him. Release yourself to him. Just release yourself to him. Release yourself to him. Oh, Jesus. Zahanke tole brantaya. Brehetoska. Bagadada mahosheya. Bandusi Christos. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. We worship you. We glorify your name. In the name of your Son Jesus, Father, receive all the worship. Receive the praise and the honor. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Let's be seated. Let's be seated. Amen. We thank God for how far he has brought us as a church, amen, and also as a family, as individuals. The Lord has been good to us, amen. By the grace of God, we are ending our fast. Hallelujah. Tomorrow after noon, you can just finish it off. Amen. Officially, it ended today. Amen. I just want to stretch because we didn't start early. So you want to stretch and add tomorrow after our prayer line, 12 noon, we end the fast officially. Hallelujah. But I'm telling the Lord has been good to us. Amen. And you will see results. Somebody say results. You will see results of our fasting. The name of the Lord be glorified. Amen. Clap and give him the praise. And as we always do, we are going to pray. Good to see you, Erin. It's been a while. I miss you. Man. And good to see everybody in the house. Just clap for yourselves. Amen. We want to just enter into the first phase of our prayer times. And can we please be on our feet? Let's be on our feet. We are going to pray against COVID. Against COVID, we're going to deal with that menace called COVID. Amen. Amen. Now they are bringing in monkeypox. They just want to confuse us. But their confusion would fall upon them. Amen. Are you hearing me? Somebody was saying that we are in the times of tribulation. And I said, no, it is a lie. Amen. Tribulation, trust me, there are even different types of tribulation. We have the tribulation and then the great tribulation. That is after the first 3.5 years is gone. Then now the great tribulation would come. Hallelujah. But we are not there yet. Amen. The church has to be raptured before the man of sin called the Antichrist would finally manifest. Amen. But as of now, the salt and the light is here. Are you hearing me? The Bible says we are the salt of the world and we are the light of this world. The body of Christ is here. Say the body of Christ. Anytime the body of Christ, anywhere the body of Christ is, the enemy does not prevail. You didn't hear what I just said. I said, anywhere the body of Christ is, the enemy does not prevail. Amen. So he says, I would build my church. The church is the body. When he was here physically, the enemy could not prevail. And he's still here in the church. Are you hearing me? And the enemy will never prevail. No, he cannot prevail against you. He might try, bring some frustrations, but in the end, it will not prevail. Even at times he will try to crucify you. But after 3 days you will come back. And even jump up better. Clap and give him the praise. Are you hearing me? So don't worry. As long as you are part of the church. No, you are fine. And just believe that you are part of the church. And do your work as part of the church. That's it. He said, I will build my church. And the gates of hell shall not prevail. Nothing of the enemy shall prevail against us. I'm telling you, until we are raptured, the enemy will not succeed. When we go, he can take the world. But we are here. We are here. We are going to pray against COVID, against all kinds of things. And we are also going to pray against this Ukraine war. And not just Ukraine, but there are so many places that we don't hear of. But because Ukraine has gained prominence, because the whole world has interest in Ukraine, are you hearing me? There are other wars that has been downplayed, but we are using that of Ukraine as a point of contact to pray that anywhere blood is being shed, let the Lord arise. Anywhere the enemy is attacking, let the Lord arise.
Amen.
We are praying in the name of Jesus that the Lord would arise. So we are praying against COVID. We are cursing the spirit of COVID, and we are praying that if perchance anyone has been attacked by this virus, let there be a healing. And number two, we are praying that the war will stop, that by the finger of God, let God arise. Let God save souls, that through this there will be salvation. Are you hearing me? Let God arise on our behalf in the name of Jesus. Lift up your hands with me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, we curse the spirit of COVID. We bind the activities of the evil one in the name of Jesus. Let your wind blow against this COVID. Let your wind blow against any menace that humanity is placing. In the name of Jesus, we declare that let the war in Ukraine and every other place cease. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood in the name of Jesus. Let there be peace. Let there be peace. Let there be peace in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray with me, somebody. Lift up your voice and pray. Lift up your voice and pray. Wherever you are, lift up your voice and pray. In the name of Jesus, we curse COVID. We curse the virus. We curse every activities of the wicked one. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we curse COVID. We declare that let the wind of God blow against this virus. Let the wind of God blow against this virus. Let the wind of God, let the wind of God, let the wind of God blow against this virus. In the name of Jesus, let the wind of God blow against this virus. Let the wind of God blow against this virus. Let the wind of God blow against this virus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we curse COVID, we curse every workings of the enemy. We curse COVID, we curse every workings of the enemy. In the name of Jesus, yekontonimis kariyaha, yegedemoho shikantali babaya, zodekedebari astus, zodekadebari astus, zodekadebari astus, ishantali baha, zobra. Dalibaha, Yabran Dalibaha, Zobran Dalibaha, Shantenemi Paya. We curse the works of the wicked one. And we declare that let the war in Ukraine cease. Let the war in Ukraine cease. Let it come to an end. We plead the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus over Ukraine, over Russia, over America. And the demons behind this. Let there be peace in the name of Jesus. And the demons behind this. Let there be peace in the name of Jesus. And the demons behind this. Let there be peace in the name of Jesus. And the demons behind us, let there be peace. We shut the mouth of demons. We shut the mouth of lions. Let the blood of Jesus be activated over Ukraine, over America, over Russia, and all the ends of the world. In the name of Jesus, we call it done. We want to continue to pray. You are praying against every works of Satan against your life, against this church. Every works of Satan, demons, principalities, powers, spiritual wickedness in high places, witchcraft activities that affects your life, that affects your family, that affects this church. We are crushing it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are condemning it. We declare that let their works catch fire.
Amen.
Let their works be set on fire.
Amen.
Let the angel of the Lord strike them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Nothing of theirs shall prevail against us.
Amen.
Nothing of theirs shall prevail against your family.
Amen.
Nothing of theirs shall prevail against the church.
Amen.
We are declaring that let their works be destroyed.
Amen.
Let them fall in the pit they dig for us. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Any wicked person, any evil entity that is against you, may they fall in the devices. Any plot they plot against you, may it backfire.
Amen.
And it will not just backfire, but it will hit them back. They will receive the reward of anything they do against us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Lift up your hands. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
I come against the works of Satan, the works of principalities, powers, witchcraft, spiritual wickedness in high places, demons, witches against my life, against my family, against this church.
In the name of Jesus,
I declare that none shall work, none shall stand. In the name of Jesus, we destroy it. We crush it. Let it catch fire. In the name of Jesus, let them fall in the pit that they dig for me, for my family, and in this church. Let any scheme be exposed. May it hit back at them. In the name of Jesus, let it hit back at them. In the name of Jesus, let them fall in every pit that they have dug. Let them fall in every trap that they have set. May it catch them. May they be exposed. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice. Wherever you are, begin to pray with me. Shadenemose akatuniskadia yazo yededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededededed
papaya. Ya raso kapante. Apantane me paya. Yedededededededededebosi ante. Ya kantone me kati antes. Ya kantone me kati antes. Inkalalaboshe. Ya kantone me pariante. Ya babababababababa. Ya kantone me pariaskilia. Ya tataria taria taria taria. Ratataria taria taria taria. Regadobo shantane me abaya. Rabababababababa. Hatole me iriaso. Libiria sakaria taya. Libiria sakaria taya. Libiria sakaria taya. Inkantone me paya. Whatever you are, lift up your voice and pray. Every attack of witchcraft against my life, against my family, both nuclear and extended family, I destroy, I crush it. And the attack against this church, I destroy, I curse, it will never stand. Any attack against my life, oh God, Ninimosi, Makanosi, Makranosi. Ishantani mimose, ikrantani mimose, ikadusti krastos, ikadusti krastos, ikadusti krastos, ikatolebi apa. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Our last prayer point, you're praying a prayer of blessing over your life, over your family, over this church. The Lord bless us. Let your reign, even both the former and the latter rain, come upon me.
Amen.
Show me favor. Show me kindness.
You are saying, Lord, open doors unto me.
Amen.
Cause me to encounter your goodness, your kindness. Let your grace be superimposed over my life.
Amen.
Even in the area of my weakness, Father, show up. Let me see your handiworks.
Amen.
Open doors unto me, Father. Open doors to this church. Cause us to enter into our promised land. Even the new meeting place, cause us to enter.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
Amen.
Every project you are undertaking, let the Lord cause you to finish that project.
Amen.
Every business you are trusting God for, let the Lord open that business.
Amen.
The Lord introduce you to people of influence and affluence. Let favor be your portion.
Amen.
The Lord bless you with money, wealth, riches and honor, opportunities. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice and pray. Wherever you are, let the Lord, let the Lord, let the Lord. Likonima sunda da babaya, rabadibiliya kataya baba, labalibiliya katala baba, labalibiliya katala baba. Ikontonimis kantele, ikontonimis kantele, rabab. Father, bless my life, bless my family, bless this church with wealth, riches and honor, favor, protection. Lord, let your hand increase upon my life. Let your favor increase upon my life. Lord God, cause us to enter the meeting place. Cause us to enter the meeting place. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Yedobo Osianta. Yedobo Osianta. Yedobo Osianta. Yedobo Osianta. Yakata Nebreata. Yakata Nebreata. Yakata Nebreata. Oh. Jesus. Lift up your hands with me. Say, Father.
Father.
I thank you.
I thank you
for your son Jesus.
For your son Jesus.
Say, Father.
Father.
I thank you.
Thank you
for salvation.
For salvation.
I thank you.
Thank you
for the blood.
For the blood
of sprinkling.
Sprinkling
that continually,
continually
washes me.
Washes.
Say, Father.
Father.
I thank you.
Thank you
for your Holy Ghost,
the Holy
who is inside of me.
Inside of
say, Holy Ghost,
Holy Ghost,
in the name of Jesus,
name of Jesus
continue to protect me.
Protect
say, Holy Ghost,
Holy Ghost,
in the name of Jesus,
name of Jesus
continue to provide for me.
Provide for
say, Holy Ghost,
Holy Ghost,
in the name of Jesus,
name of Jesus
continue to reveal Christ
unto me.
Say, now, Lord,
in the name of Jesus,
glorify your Son Jesus
in my life
and in our midst,
even now
and forever.
Forever
in Jesus' name.
Jesus,
somebody clap and give him the praise. Let's be seated. Once again, I want to welcome all of us to our Friday service. Amen. We bless God, Mount Zion hour, and trust me, things are happening, and nowadays I'm going to be very aggressive towards testimonies. Amen. Because the testimonies I'm hearing are mind-blowing. They are mind-blowing. And I pray that soon and very soon, the Lord will put a new song in somebody's mouth. The Lord will put a new song in somebody's mouth. Somebody clap and give him the praise. Amen. And we want to welcome our online family who are watching. The Lord bless you. And also to a very special brother who has been watching us all the way from the UK, Brother Sadiq Peters. We just want to say we love you, and the Lord bless you. We appreciate the connection. Amen. And it's good to be in the house of the Lord. It's always good to have us connected as a people of God. Amen. And as we end in the fasting, we just want to go through some of the things that our Father raised. Amen. If someone has invented the wheel, you don't go to reinvent. Amen. There is one thing that I know about my Father and our Father in the person of Reverend Eastwood, our spiritual father, that man is when we say somebody labors in the word. Oh no. He grinds. He does everything. He digs, he grinds, and by the time he comes out with the word, you see that yes, a laborer has gone to labor. Amen. And we thank God for his life. Daddy, wherever you are, I want to say thank you. Thank you for the work you do in by laboring in the scriptures. Amen. And during this past 3 weeks that we entered in, especially the last week, he dealt with the spirit of the Philistines. I'm dealing with the Philistine spirit, if you have been following online. Amen. And just by the way, Daddy is coming back on the 2nd and the 3rd of July. Amen. I'm just throwing this out there to our online family. Our daddy is coming back on the 2nd and the 3rd of July. It will be a Saturday evening service, and then Sunday morning we'll have a joint service at 10 o'clock. And in the evening, he's coming back to have an anointing service with us. Amen. And the theme is settlement. Say settlement. We are going to enforce some things. Some things must happen by force. The violent take some things by force. Are you hearing me? One time God told the people of Israel, you are going to the promised land. But as you are going, go and battle them. Go and battle the Anakins. So there are some things you must, even though it's yours, you have to battle and take them. Because the enemy who is a squatter is trying to prevent you from taking what belongs to you. Are you hearing me? So the violence shall what? Take it. Some things that belong to you might be taken by force. May God grant you the spirit of aggression. May you be aggressive in the spirit. May you not just settle for anything. Are you hearing me? May you take what belongs to you. You see it and say, no, this thing is mine. And I'm going for it. May God give us that grace. Somebody clap and give him the praise. We are looking at four things, but for the sake of time, we will deal with two today, and then we'll pray the other two next week, Friday. Is somebody hearing me? The four things, or many things amongst which he spoke, I picked just four for us to about the spirit of the Philistines. Amen. And the first thing he dealt with was that they were well blockers. Say well blockers. The well blockers. And the other thing he taught us was that they are ark capturers. They capture the ark. And then the third one is they are seducers. Say seducers. They will seduce you from off your mark. The art of seduction is to hypnotize you, is to catch your attention and to draw you from your focus. Are you hearing me? They seduce you out of your destiny. And that will be next week, Friday. We'll be dealing with the seducers and also the intimidators. Say intimidators. The Philistines, they intimidate. Oh, I'm telling you, they will intimidate you. And if you see the word intimidate has to do with intimidate. So if you buy into intimidation, you become timid towards the things that belongs to you. Are you hearing me? So next week, Friday, we will deal with that aspect of the spirit of Philistines. No, from today, may you not be intimidated by anybody. No. May nothing intimidate you. May no money intimidate you. That some of us, when we see 5 billion, we'll collapse. May God give you the capacity. Oh, clap and give him the praise. Some of us have settled. We have stayed so long at hundreds and thousands that when you are introduced to millions, oh no, somebody will collapse. When somebody sees about $50 million, the person will collapse. But may nothing intimidate you. May you be able to handle billions, and yet you are serving as an usher. Is somebody hearing me? May you be handling billions and trillions, and you are serving as a choir. You are serving in the house of the Lord. May you be handling big things. Paul said, I know how to abase and how to abound. May that be your portion. May nothing intimidate you. So next week we'll look at intimidators. And then we will look at the last one, which is not the last, but among what we have, and seducers. So today we are looking at we are praying alongside the well blockers and the ark capturers. Say the well blockers and the ark capturers. So I'll just pick up the scripture and then we will run with it. Amen. Okay, let's look at A scripture here in the book of Genesis, chapter number 26, the verse 12 to 25. If we have it here. Genesis 26, the verse 12 to 25. It says, and Isaac sowed in that land and received in the same year a hundredfold, and the Lord blessed him. And the man waxed great and went forward and grew until he became very great. For he had possessions of flock and possessions of herds and great store of servants. Say great store. And the Philistines envied him. You see, the last time I told you here that until you are envied by your riches, you are not yet rich. If you have just 10, 20,000, 100,000 in your accounts, the government will not envy you. Are you hearing me? Recently, I saw a feud between, is it Jeff Bezos and some people? Elon Musk and some people. I say, yes, this is envy. Now, may that be your portion. May it come to pass that when you decide to draw your money from the bank will call you and come to your house and sit down with you. I'm prophesying upon somebody's life right now. I said, I'm prophesying upon somebody's life right now. May it happen to you. May you be so wealthy that you will be building churches. Churches, churches. You speak church everywhere you go. Recently, somebody was celebrating the birthday, and I saw so many posts. The Lord make you great. The Lord favor you. I didn't say anything. I just sent cash up. Bam! And the person responded, the Lord bless you. The Lord bless you, man of God. The Lord, I say, yes. This is more than birthday wishes. May God bless everybody. May God make us generous people. No, people are tired of worse. Worse. I sent some serious cash out, bam! And the person responded, man of God, the Lord bless you. I said, he will bless me. Somebody clap and give him the praise. Amen. He says, and the Philistines, they envied him. You see, as long as you remain poor, you'll not be envied. I'm telling you. Now, some people, when you are lower than them, they will like you. They are fine. As long as you are low and they are high, they are fine. But when you begin to rise and they see you coming, they will not even be intimidated as long as you don't get to their level. But when you get there and you begin to go up, and there is a problem. Are you hearing me? And they envied him. From today, may you be lifted up. May you be lifted. May you rise above anyone who is looking down upon you. May you rise. Oh, when we began as a church, well, even when we began, we still were envied. Because they saw our potential. They said, these guys, if we don't stop them. So right when we were four, they were still envying us. I said, Abba, you are big. Leave us alone and just focus on yourself. But they saw what was about to come. Are you hearing me? They saw it. They said, no, these guys, if we don't stop them. Recently, one of them called me. He said, hey, pastor, the Lord bless you. I said, he will bless me. The things this and this and this have done to you and they have said about you. I said, it is well. You see, if the Lord is with you, no man can be against you. And the Philistines envied him. Next. For all the wells which his father's servant had digged in the days of Abraham his father, the Philistines had what? Stopped them and filled them with earth. I won't go further. So the spirit of the Philistines is to what? Always block your efforts. And mind you, these wells belong to his father, Abraham. They were his rightful inheritance. Abraham had the bona fide, I mean, these were his by reason of what? Inheritance. And yet, the spirit of the Philistines would contend with whatever belongs to you. So tonight, we are going to pray against, you see, it is the same devil and the same demons that have existed since time immemorial. Are you hearing me? The same tactics, but different vessels. So, the same demons that used the Philistines against the anointed, the covenant child, is still using people against us. Just as different packages, but the same spirit and the same modus operandus. But the Bible says we are not ignorant of their devices. So in dealing with the spirit of the Philistines in those days, we are still dealing with the same spirits in our time. So in our prayer points, anything that seeks to stop the wells we are digging. You see, our daddy said something, that wells are a source of water. When you dig wells, you get water. Are you hearing me? And also, even when you are drilling oil, they dig wells to get oil. So it could be also a source of wealth. And water is a source of life. But these Philistines will make sure that they block them. The spirit tends to block the source of your wealth. You are working so hard to make it in life, and these spirits, through human entities, are blocking them to frustrate you, to make sure that you don't attain where that which you are supposed to attain. But the devil is a liar. I said the devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. The same God who helped Isaac to overcome is our God. He's called the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. Is somebody hearing me? He is the Father of our Lord Jesus. The same God that caused them to overcome is with us. The same God. So the same devil and the same God. Blockers, they block the wells. They see a potential and say, no, if we leave this guy, what he will bring to this land? No. And the Philistines block the wells. From today, I curse every activities of well blockers. Anything that seeks to block your wealth, your riches, your honor, anything that blocks your anointing, anything that frustrates the flow of the grace of God over your life, in the name of Jesus, I pronounce a curse upon that thing. I said, any person that stands your way to declare that you are for you, they will block your wealth. They will make sure that you don't succeed in life. From today, I pronounce a curse. I declare that your wealth will never stand. Is somebody hearing me? I declare upon your life that you are the seed of Jacob. You belong to Jesus. You are the seed of Abraham. And if God did it for Jacob, if God did not allow the Philistines to succeed in the case of Jacob, listen to me, somebody, they will not succeed against you. I see your wells coming up. I see you digging a well, and I see the waters coming up. You will drink from your own cistern. I said you will drink from your own wells. Nobody shall block your well. Nobody shall succeed against your well. I came to prophesy in the name of Jesus. He said, Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, the same today, and the same forever. I brought the word of prophecy. I see you dig a well, and I see you drinking from that well. I pray in the name of Jesus. And the Lord is telling me to tell somebody that you are about to even enter into a place that you drink from wells that you did not think. I said you will drink from wells that you never dug. May that be your portion. They will dig and you go and drink. Is somebody hearing me? In that promised land, they never dug wells. The wells were darker.
the houses were built and the Lord called them to enter, may you enter into somebody's inheritance. I said, may you enter into somebody's inheritance. I prophesied over somebody that you are about to enter into inheritance. You are about to enter into somebody's labor in the name of Jesus. He said, look the field, for they are white. Are you hearing me? I see prosperity. I see wealth, riches, and honor. I see favor coming upon you. From today, any wealth blockers, anyone that has attacked your wealth, let the hand of the Lord come against that person. Anyone that has attacked your wealth, I pray the wells are bringing water. I see wells bringing oil. I see wells bringing oil. Wealth and connections. Favor. Somebody clap and give him the praise.
Wells. The Philistines, they want to block the source of life. They are blocking our wells. But I'm telling you, light has come to us. Knowledge has come to us. The entrance of thy word giveth illumination to the simple. From today, I pray in the name of Jesus that anything that is a well in your life, even in your spirit, say to them that believe, out of their belly shall flow with rivers of living waters. One plan of the devil is to block your spirit with the news you will hear, the things you hear and you see. It becomes a world blocker. It blocks the flow of the Holy Ghost to the extent and the intent that you can't pray at times. You try to pray and it looks like the world is blocked. Something is blocked. Your prayer life is not like it used to be. I brought the word of God upon somebody. I came with a word that from today you are about to speak in some new language. You are about to pray for hours. I see your prayer language changing. I see God come for you. You are going to pray for hours. Every blockade, anything that block your prayer life, you are entering into a new level of prayer, a prayer zone. To them that believe, out of their belly, out of their belly, out of their belly, I see out of your spirit coming. Let the wells flow. Let the wells flow. Let the well flow. Let the well flow. In the name of Jesus, let the wells flow. Let out of your spirit, I see new ideas coming, new anointing coming, new favor coming. Any bad news that block your wells, we overshadow the news in the name of Jesus. I brought a word of refreshing in your life today. Let the wind of God breathe over you. I see every block well being taken out of the way. And the wells that they blocked, in the name of Jesus, new strength, and them that wait upon the Lord, and I renew their strength. I see you flying like an eagle. You are running and you are walking and not being faint. You are not being weary because you are mounting up the wings of an eagle. The Holy Ghost is coming upon somebody, and the blockages and the blockade in your spirit, I took it out. And the poison they brought your way, and the bad news they brought your way, from today I curse that news. I curse anything that the devil brought your way. I am so fresh. I am so anointed to preach this gospel. I declare in the name of Jesus, it's called the good news, the gospel of Jesus, to bind the brokenhearted. I came to tell somebody that the spirit of the Lord is upon me. Oh, every well that has been blocked, every well that has been blocked, I release. Let your joy come back. The Bible says, with joy they shall draw. The joy they shall draw from the wells of salvation. Are you hearing me? Anything that affected your joy, from today I take it out of the way. I declare that by the Holy Ghost, let your joy come back. Let your joy come back. For the joy of the Lord is our strength. Somebody be on your feet as we engage in prayers. We engage in prayers. Oh God. Shatakabadeke nemaha. Mandalala bose. Ikada masunda bahaya. Oh, today I am just riding on the wings of my father. I am just riding on the wings of my father. My father dug this well, and I'm drinking from the wells of my father. Are you hearing me? Manunimi Zagrandokaya. My father dug this well, and I'm just drawing
wine from the wells of my father. You are going to pray in the name of Jesus that from today, any wall blocker, any person, any spirit, the spirit of the Philistines, any wall blocker, any wall blocker, any news that blocks your joy, anything that blocks your prosperity, anything that blocks your flow, we are casting that then in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray. Pray, pray. Aluli Krados. Haba 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 Abraham Doliba, Abraham Dariaba, Abraham, 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 Shataka, Shataka, Shataka. This is my well. This is my well. I will draw from my well, from the wells of salvation. Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God. With joy, we shall draw. Abba Adani Mose, Ada Adani Abaya, Yege Nebo Santana Mipa, Yege Nebo Santana Mipa, Yege Nebo Santana Mipa, Yege Nebo Santana Mipa. We cast every well blocker. We cast every well blocker. We cast, we cast. It affects the flow. It affects the flow. It affects the flow. It can do me, brother. The flow of wealth. The flow of life. The flow of resources. The flow of water. In the name of Jesus. Liborikaba. Ikadolebra. Ikadalabra. Lift up your voice and pray. Every well blocker, every well blocker, every well blocker, we cast out of our way. We bind that well blocker and we cast them out. In the name of Jesus, it is our well. We have inherited from our Father. Ligadaba, ligadaba so and ligadaba so. Shataka, yakaka.
Listen, listen, listen. And the Lord was telling me that at times, see, well, when the well is flowing, when you're drawing, it enhances flow. Say flow. Flow. But a well blocker can be a person who, when someone is trying to flow you with something, promotion, some blessing, the well blocker will whisper into the ears of the person in charge of the flow. And by reason of his information or information, the flow will cease. That person has become a well blocker. But today we curse the works of any well blocker. Are you hearing me? Any person through whom any blessing is being cut from us, we take the person out of the way.
Amen.
Out of that job. From today, anyone sitting on your promotion, from today, anyone sitting on your pay raise, on your papers at the immigration, your papers
wherever the papers must come from, anyone sitting on it is a word blocker. Amen. We take the person out of the way.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. It is the spirit of the Philistine. We are praying against that person that from today, anyone sitting on any flow that belongs to us, let the wind of the spirit blow that person away.
Amen.
Say, Father, in the name of Jesus,
any
world blocker in my life, in my family, in this church, anyone sitting on my blessing, anyone sitting on my information, my papers, my race, my business, is a world blocker. Let the wind of God blow that person. Let the hand of God cast that person. I cast that person. I take that person out in the name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and pray against the world blockers. 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 The world blockers, against the world blockers. Shut up, Mahate. Let the wind of God, let the hand of God be cotikiria, be cotikiria, be cotikiria. Shut up, Mahate. Subrande, subrande, subrande. Zubrande he Shatakaba Azubadi Kari Apokaba. It is a world blocker. It is a world blocker. It is blocking the flow. In the name of Jesus. We take out any world blocker. We cast out any world blocker. We cast out any world blocker. We cast out. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the next 2 minutes, we are praying a prayer. It's a declaration, a prophecy, and all that. That from today, you will drink from wells. There will be a flow in your life. There will be a flow in your spiritual life. There will be a flow in your financial life. Even in your relationship, there will be a flow. Everything that has to do with you, you will drink from wells. You will drink from wells. You will drink from wells. You will drink from wells in the name of the Lord Jesus. Lift up your voice and prophesy over your life. Declare over your life that this church will drink from wells. We will drink from wells. We will drink from wells. We will drink from wells. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we will drink from wells. I declare that I will drink from every source. I will drink from wells. I drink, I receive wealth, riches, honor, life, water, everything. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Ikodis Kobra Ante. Ikodis Kobra.
Shadabaha Bagadonibaha Yekerebata Librantanibipa Basunda Mariata. The well, oh God, Sadakato Nebriha Lidedebosha Bakatanibi Soka Pagata. In the name of Jesus, the Bible says, and when Jacob was running from home, he went towards his uncle Laban's place in Syria. And when he got there, he met this beautiful lady called Rachel by the well. Say, by the well. Carrying the father's sheep. She was waiting that the well, the stone in front of the well will be rolled so she can feed, water the sheep. Are you hearing me? And one day the Lord Jesus told me, 131st night here, he said, when they put me, after I died and they put me in that tomb and they used the stone to cover me, it was like a well that has been blocked. And then the angel rolled the stone. And by then, the Lord has come out. Are you hearing me? The well has been opened. And the river of life has been released unto us. From today, let nothing deprive you of receiving from Jesus. The well of life has been released unto the world. Jesus is out of the tomb. The river of life has been unleashed unto us. I pray a time of refreshing, a time of release. Against any difficulty, you are watching us online, I prophesy that the stone has been removed. Amen. The unblocking has been released. Amen. And there is a fresh release of anointing. Amen. Provisions. Amen. Over your life. Amen. I bless you in the name of Jesus. Somebody clap and give him the praise. Let's receive our communion. Let's receive our communion. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You're watching us online, just lift up the elements of communion. Lift up the bread. If you are here with me, just lift up. It is the body of Christ. The same body that was crucified and put in the tomb. It's like a well. So as you are partaking it, you are declaring that your healing has been released. The stone has been rolled and life has been released unto us. He gave us his body to partake. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, this is the body of your son Jesus. I declare that by this token, I am healed. By this token, every blockings of my well has been released. I receive every content from the well of life. In Jesus' name, amen. Somebody take it. You want to lift up the blood. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, this is the blood of your son, Jesus.
I receive it. I partake in it. I declare that let every content in the blood, the life, the power, the voice of the blood be activated in my favor. In Jesus' name, I call it done. Amen. Somebody receive it. You want to pick your oil? You're watching us online. Just lift it up. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray over this oil. I ask for the release of your grace that as we apply this oil, let an anointing be released upon us to cast out any world blockers in our lives, to unblock any wells that has been blocked, to receive from life, to partake in everything in our wells that you have given us. We thank you that it is done. In Jesus' name, amen. Just anoint yourself and prophesy over your lives that from today, no more blocking of wells. Every well that has been blocked is being unblocked. You are drinking from your wells, your own cisterns, and even to the extent that you are drinking from wells that you did not dig. You are drinking from wells, both from your wells and wells that you did not dig. May you sleep in houses you did not build. In the name of the Lord Jesus, drinking from wells, drinking, partaking in riches, in life, in the abundance of your inheritance in Christ Jesus. In Christ Jesus. We call it done. In Jesus' name. Amen. Somebody just give it unto him. Give it unto him. Give it unto him. Give it unto him. Oh, you're clapping. We are not clapping like fountain gators. Let's do it like fountain gators. Hallelujah. Amen. You know, one thing about us is noise. Positive noise. Are you hearing me? Not just any noise. Positive noise. Amen. Impactful and meaningful noise. Noise of a saved people. Hallelujah. So we are making noise because we have been saved. We are making noise because we have been delivered by the Lord. We are making noise because God is our Father. Amen. The book of Thessalonians says that the Lord would come down with a shout. The Lord himself would come down with a shout and with the voice of an angel, the trump. Hallelujah. So we believe in positive noise. Amen. Where there is no noise, it means that people are dead. Even when a child is born and the child is not crying, they pinch the child. They give him some to make some noise. Are you hearing me? From today, if I see that I don't make noise, I will pinch you. I want to test whether there is life. You see, noise is indicative of life. If there is life, there will be noise. Clap and give him the praise. Amen. You want to prepare your offering, your tithes, something good for the Lord. You want to celebrate him. You want to appreciate him. If you have any pledge you want to do towards the building fund, we are trying to move out of this place. In fact, we are moving, amen, to our promised land. You want to trust Jesus? Thank you, Lord. Maruske.
Lord, I come, I confess, bowing here, I find my rest. Without you, I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you.
my righteousness. Oh, oh, I need
you. Oh, Lord, I need you.
I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My righteousness. My righteousness. Oh, I need.
Come on, somebody, just celebrate him. Clap and give him the praise. Look to your neighbor and tell him or her that from tonight, every well blocker has been cast out. And every well that has been blocked is unblocked. Say, from tonight, I will drink from my wells. And I will drink from wells that I did not dig. I call it done in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Stretch forth your hands towards the offerings. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for tonight. Thank you for inspiring us by your word. Thank you for your anointing. Thank you that you've gone ahead of us to hand over things that belongs to us into our hands. Thank you that by your spirit, we are drinking from our wells. And even from wells we did not dig. Thank you for your rain, your blessings, and your honor upon this church and upon our lives. I declare this offering sanctified with the blood. I ask that, Father, you bless your people. Cause them to enter into their inheritance and to see your glory. I thank you that it is done. In Jesus' name. Amen. As we were praying, I saw like an helicopter flying. It was a military helicopter that has crashed. So I pray in the name of Jesus to avert any calamity within this week, any disaster that demons have planned against any chopper. I cancel it in Jesus' name. Amen. Somebody clap and give him the praise. We want to share the words of the grace and have our declaration on the screen. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. In 2022, I'm fulfilling my purpose by having ownership of properties, by taking my rightful position in the community, by exercising the power of the Holy Ghost, and by attaining perfection in Christ Jesus. Amen. The Lord bless you. I love you. I'll see you all on Sunday. Amen.